everyone. In this video, I'm going to take a look at my favorite new features with the Reminders app in macOS Sonoma. We can now add sections to our Reminders lists, and if we're creating a grocery list, the Reminders app will create sections for us automatically. And then we can also view our Reminders lists in columns. Let's take a look at these three new features with the Reminders and macOS Sonoma. Let's go over to my Mac. Let's first take a look at sections. If we go over to my hardware list here, this is a list that I need to get when I go over to the hardware store. What I would like to do is group these items together by section. As an example, I have hoses here, and then I also have fertilizer and a rake. That belongs in the gardening section. And then I also have light bulbs as well as an extension cord. That belongs in electrical, so when I'm in the electrical section, I can see all these items grouped together. Well, with macOS Sonoma, we can easily add these sections. So how do we do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we just need to go up under Edit in the menu bar, and what you're going to see here is Add Section. Now, this will change into Manage Sections once I add my first sections. You'll see this shortly. Since I do not have any sections in this list, it's just add sections. So let's go ahead and add a section. Select it, and we're going to go with gardening. So I just type in here gardening, hit return. So now I have my gardening section. Let's go and add two more. We're going to go back up under edit, and then you're going to see it says manage sections. So this is what I mean by it changes once you add a section. So how do you go and add a section? Well, you just basically go over to the right and you're going to see add section. So I select it, and we're going to go with electrical. And then we want to add one more. So we go back up under edit, we go over to manage sections, and then we go over to add section. Select it, and we're going to go with outdoor. So now I have my sections in there. Now what I need to do is I need to place my items in there. So how do we do that? Well, we just use simple drag and drop. So this hoses here, these are garden hoses. So I'm going to just drag this up under gardening here. We can see that the blue line here is underneath gardening. So I just let it go, and now hoses is under there. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. Electrical for light bulbs, a cooler is outdoor, sprinklers are gardening. So we just drag and drop, place them where we want. Fertilizer is gardening, and we're going to go with one more. Rake is gardening. So now I have them grouped together. Now what we're able to do when they're in sections is easily add another item to that section. If I wanted to add another item for gardening, maybe I need grass seed. I go down to the section here and I type in grass seed and it places it in my gardening section here. If I wanted to add something to electrical, I just go to electrical here and add it there. If I don't want to add anything to one of these sections, I can also go down to the very bottom here, and you're going to see that I can add one down at the very bottom. This will not add it to a specific section. We can also close these sections, so I can view just one section at a time just by clicking on these carrots here. And then if I want to manage the sections, I just go back up under Edit. We go over to Manage Sections. And then you're going to see edit. And from here, I'm able to move them around as well as rename them. So that is our sections. Now, what Apple did is they took this a step further with grocery lists. It will add the sections for us automatically to a grocery list. Let's see what I mean. So I have these grocery items here. This is my grocery list. So you can see I have apples, oranges, watermelon. I also have some meats and some dairy and some bread. Now what I could do is just go back up under edit here and add sections and then do that manually. But like I mentioned, Apple does this for us automatically with grocery items. So what we need to do is we need to turn this list here, this grocery items list, into a grocery list. By default, it's a standard list. This is what we're used to, a standard list. So how do we do that? Well, basically, we just control click on this and you're going to see show list info, select it. This is where we can go and name it and color it as well as add icons. But this is also where we can change the list type. As I mentioned, by default, it's going to be a standard list. When I select this, I can select groceries. And now when I click on OK, it's going to automatically add sections and add those individual items to that section. So let's see what I mean. Click on OK. And now we can see we have my produce section, and it added the apples, oranges, and watermelon to that section. With meat, I have my ham and hot dogs. With breads and cereals, I have hot dog buns and dinner rolls. And then with dairy, I have my milk and cheese. I want to add more items. All I have to do is just click in here and I can add more items to a specific section. This works just like any other sections that I just covered. I can add my own sections to it by going up under Edit and then going to Manage Sections and Adding Sections. Then I can also edit them. So in addition to creating sections with the grocery list, it'll go and create the sections for us automatically. So that's how we work with grocery lists and sections. I really love that particular feature. The last feature I'm going to show you is how we can view our reminders as a column. This is great for project management. It's kind of like a Kanban view, if you're familiar with those. Let's go over to my macOS Sonoma. This is my different projects that I'm working on. So I click on it, and we can see I have a section. We want to use sections with this. You'll see why shortly. I have a section for recording. These are the videos that I want to record. I also have a section for editing, and then I have a section for posting them. And then I can mark them as complete when I am done with them. So this is kind of like a very basic project manager. And it works good in this list. But what I would like to do is view this as columns. When you view it as columns, we can actually see these different items grouped together a little bit better. Great for project management, as I said. So how do we do that? Well, basically, all we have to do is just go up under View, and what you're going to see is as columns. You're going to view this as columns. So I select it, and now we can see we have my columns here. And if I had more columns, I just swipe over to the right to view other ones. I can drag and drop between these. Maybe Safari Profiles isn't recorded yet. Well, I can just take this and drag it over to my recorded section. Maybe I have shared passwords recorded. I can take this and drag it over to Edit, because now I need to edit it. To open them up, you just click on the eye, and you still have all of the same information. It's still a reminder. I can go and add notes to it. I can add tags. I can even set it to remind me at a specific day or location. It just changes the view into column view. If you want to change it back, you can go back under View and change it back to a list. So you're just swapping the view there. So those are my three favorite features that Apple added with the Reminders app in macOS Sonoma. I really love the idea of sections, and it's great that we can manage those and add those, and it's pretty easy to do. But with a grocery list, which my wife and I do keep a grocery list, I really love how it adds those sections for us automatically. When you do that, it will carry over to the iPhone, and then you can just mark that off on your iPhone while you're at the grocery store. You do have to be using iOS 17 for that to work. And then, of course, we have column view. So now you can use the Reminders app as more of a project manager as well. So those are my three favorite new features with macOS Sonoma and the Reminders app on the Mac.